practicing OBGYN. So the World Patient Safety Day, we would like to take some time to, as I've already told you, to regarding busting out these myths. The first myth is that the patients, what they, the undercurrent and their beliefs, they, what they presume it to be, that they do not need a doctor to evaluate whether it is safe for me to use in, to take an Ocipel or not. I would like to urge all my patients, and I would like to make them know that at least you need an opinion. If you have nearby your consultant, and you can just approach her, and your doctor needs to evaluate whether it is safe for you to take an Ocipel on the basis and on this evaluation, on the basis of this, it will be safe to suggest whether an Ocipel is right family planning method for you. I'll be able to recommend the right Ocipel formulation to suit your individual needs. Myth 2 is what the generally patients experience is the long-term Ocipels use is the best method to cure period pain. What I would say that Ocipels are of course one of the most effective methods to relieve period pain in young girls and young women if taken regularly for 3 months. However, if you are having intense and continuous period pain which extends beyond the time of menses, get yourself evaluated for underlying gynecological diseases which are really, really prevalent and very common these days, which we generally keep on encountering with every other OPD patients which we are coming across, and that is the PCOS, endometriosis, and pelvic inflammatory disease, fibroids, polyps. Now the third common question that keeps on banging, I can never get pregnant despite irregular Ocipel use. So this is not so, because the daily use of the Ocipel as directed by OBGYN is proven to prevent your unwanted pregnancy, only 7% failure rate. So missing your daily pills without an additional without using an additional barrier method of contraception can increase the risk of pregnancy significantly, because the Ocipel use will result in the clots in the blood. The risk of clot is overall very low with the combined oral contraceptives. The risk of clot is higher for pregnant women than the non-pregnant women. Estrogen in the combined oral contraceptive increases the risk of blood clot in a leg or lungs. Since the combined oral contraceptive now which we use and the formulations which are available and which we promote and we generally write in our prescriptions, they have a very low dose of estrogen, almost very negligible dose of estrogen. That is why a continuum is required every day to have the pill exert and influence and execute its action. Because if you miss the pill, that low dose thing is not going to work. So since the dose of the estrogen and the progesterone combined is so low that it's not going to have any blood clotting effect. So there is no risk, increased risk of the clot. Combined Ocipels also contain specific type of progestins which are also in a very low quantity that is not going to increase any clot risk. However, if you take any other formulation which contain only progestogen, that has a profound risk, and the COC which are available, which are common and which we generally prescribe, they are the choice. They are individualized based on the factors. So we should always talk to your doctor about the risk of the blood clots when deciding which pill will fit you. Now the fifth perturbing and concerning question, that the risk of infertility or delayed return of the fertility with Ocipel long-term use. So COC does not cause infertility. This is true regardless of how long a woman has taken the pill, the number of children the woman has had, or the age of women. In fact, some of the non-contraceptive benefits of the pill for preserving fertility by offering protection against pelvic inflammatory disease, endometriosis, ectopic pregnancy, and there is no evidence that combined oral contraceptive pill delays a woman return to fertility after she stops taking them. Women who stop using COC can become pregnant as quickly as a woman who stop using non-hormonal methods. Another question which generally our patient asks is, I heard that combined OC pill can cause birth defects. So there's enough evidence that OC pill will not cause any birth defect in the fetus, and it will not otherwise harm the fetus in case you become pregnant while taking OC pills, or accordingly start taking OC pills when already pregnant. And the another doubt, another this thing, deterrent and opinion which generally ladies have, that it may cause cancer, the OC pill, are just opposite phenomena which we have. It's going to offer you a lot of safety, and it is proven that COC is proven to decrease the risk of ovarian endometrial carcinoma. And however, it is difficult to ascertain the risk of COC use in breast cancer and cervical cancer. Now again, the eighth problem that which surrounds the mind and blocks the mind of the users is that COC will cause their hair loss, weight gain, asthma, nausea, headaches. So short-term side effects such as changes in the bleeding patterns, headaches, nausea are expected, but these side effects are a sign of illness and not directly related to it, and usually stop within few months of the use of COC. Many patients have been asking about the weight gain. With the use, most of the women do not gain or lose weight because of COC. It may fluctuate naturally due to changes in age or lifestyle. However, a few women experience sudden weight changes when using COC, but these are reversible and these are transient, and which is not going to stay with you. It has been a great session, and now it's time to take me leave. I hope you all got doubts resolved through this, and I'll help you to me when it you say that I'm fine. Thank you so much to be here with me, with all of you, and really, really being a part of it. I'm really thankful from the core of my heart. Thank you so much.